Welcome friends, in this episode we are going to discuss about the concept and structure of the proposed modern indirect tax structure in India, that is GST. What is GST? Before we understand the proposed GST law, it's more important for all of us to understand the current indirect tax structure. Currently, on various economic activities, for example, if you are buying and selling goods, typically termed as trading activity, you are liable to pay VAT. If you are engaged in the activity of manufacture, you are liable to pay a duty of excise, which is collected by the central government. At the same time, if you are availing certain services or providing certain services, which are known as taxable services, you are liable to pay service tax. There are certain economic activities such as entertainment on which the state government is levying entertainment tax. So it can be observed that currently the indirect tax structure is pretty complex, and that's why the government remove all this complex indirect tax structure is proposing to introduce GST. So what is GST? GST is a modern tax structure which is approximately prevalent in more than 160 countries across the world. Even when we are talking about UN members, you will realize that out of total 193 United Nations members, only 41 countries do not have GST in place. If we are talking about, like say, 2009 onwards, there are 9 countries who have introduced GST in their respective countries. Recent example of introduction of GST being Malaysia. Malaysia, from 1st of April 2015, has introduced GST. The rate of GST in Malaysia is only 6%. Now, India is also talking about introduction of GST from 1st of April 2016. When we look at the multiple deadlines which are missed in the last few decades, such as the UPA government had also proposed introduction of GST earlier. However, the deadline was missed. Now, the new NDA government, which is in power, has also proposed that from 1st of April 2016, the new proposed GST law will be in place. So whether this deadline would be missed or whether the government will stick to it, that we will find out obviously in the days to come. But because we are left with only 340 days to understand the impact and the relevance of GST, it's of predominant importance for all of us to understand what is this proposed GST law.